duplicate the communication exactly. You will reach your own distorted interpretation. If I were to tell you that the children had to leave at crepuscule, you might wonder what I am talking about, unless you understand the word crepuscule. Crepuscule simply means the time of the day when the sun is just below the horizon, especially the period between sunset and dark. The sentence now makes sense, doesn't it? In school, many of us were taught to simply guess at the meanings of words by looking at the surrounding context. This, of course, is a very unreliable method of study, as the person writing the text had a specific concept to communicate and chose the words based on specific understandings. If you want to receive the information in the same light, you must share the same understanding of the words used to convey it, not come to subjective understandings based on what you think the words might mean. Author Philip Dick once wrote, "The basic tool for the manipulation of reality is the manipulation of words. If you can control the meaning of words, you can control the people who must use the words." This is especially relevant to constitutional matters. An insidious way to pervert the Constitution and Bill of Rights is to pervert or obscure, whether intentionally or otherwise, the meaning of the words the framers carefully chose. Failing to comprehend the original meaning of these documents guarantees that the original message will be lost in translation, and maybe one day even deemed outmoded and irrelevant in modern society. This is actually a familiar concept in jurisprudence, aligning with the rule of construction, which holds that if a plain meaning of a law exists, it should be followed. As Justice Joseph Story said, the first and fundamental rule in the interpretation of all instruments is to construe them according to the sense of the terms and intention of the parties. If a plain meaning does not exist, the reader must construe the language of the text so as not to contradict the document at any point, and the reader must seek meaning in its purposes or in the principles that it embodies as understood from its nature and objects, its scope and design. To preserve the original meaning and application of the Bill of Rights, this book will take a unique approach. It will not teach you my interpretation of the Bill of Rights, or anyone else's for that matter.